Today, we are at a site with a Kenwood AC set to 16 degrees. The unit is running, and the outdoor unit is also operating, but despite this, it's not cooling the room. Today, we'll explain the mistakes they've made that are preventing the room from cooling at all. We're now checking the unit and notice that the fan is running, but the compressor starts, then stops after a while, and repeats this cycle. First, we'll show you what the issue might be. As you can see, I have set up the meters here with both an ammeter and a voltmeter connected. Let me show you the voltage. It's reading at 163 volts. Operating the AC at 163 volts is challenging, so let's see why the voltage is so low. Due to this low voltage, the compressor is overheating and tripping repeatedly. Even though there is power, the compressor keeps tripping. We'll first fix the electrical issue, and then continue to see if there are any other problems. As you can see, they are using a stabilizer, but it's outputting low voltage. Now let's check the stabilizer to see what the issue might be, as we'll examine both its input and output. When we check its input and output, we can see that meters are connected here. The input is currently between 150-160 volts, and the output is around 210 to 220 volts. However, the final result is still low. Now the AC is completely fixed, so let's connect the ammeter again. I'm hopeful that the unit will now work properly. The ammeter is connected, and we'll wait for the unit to stabilize and for the compressor and fan to start. We'll have to wait a bit to see if the unit is functioning correctly or not. It's been about 3 to 4 minutes since we started the unit, and we can see that the amperage is fluctuating as it stabilizes, which is a good sign, because the unit is starting at proper amperage. Ensuring stable electricity is also important to confirm that the work we've done is correct. We're getting a voltage reading of 219 volts, which is good, and the amperage is at 6.2, which is also a positive sign, meaning the cooling will be effective. The compressor is sounding good, and the fan is working perfectly as well. Now we've moved to the indoor unit, and as you can see, the cooling has become excellent, and the room temperature has improved significantly, so the unit is now functioning well. You might be wondering why we haven't mentioned the mistake the technician made. Let's explain the mistake the electrician made, which almost caused the unit to fail. Let's go over all the details. Now let's see what the fault was. The electrician connected the supply incorrectly. The input should have been here, and the output should have been there. But what happened is, the wire going into the AC is connected to the output, meaning it shouldn't be in the input side. Instead, the main supply is connected to the input, which is the mistake. Let's fix this and check the correct positioning. Now, we've changed the connections. At the input, we're getting 224 volts, but when we check the output, it's showing 279 volts. Which is too high. This means there's an issue with the stabilizer. Since the stabilizer isn't functioning correctly, it's not working properly. Now, we've removed the stabilizer and connected the electricity directly. We've disconnected the stabilizer and are checking it now, examining its output and other aspects. We're trying to adjust it because there's an issue with the voltage. After supplying the electricity and turning it on, we're seeing 275 volts, which is too high. Now, we'll make the necessary adjustments. The stabilizer is now fixed. The issue was that one of its wires had a soldering joint that came loose. We've now replaced the soldered joint by directly connecting the wire. As you can see, we've connected it securely. This is why it wasn't switching properly before. Now, the voltage is reading 228 to 229 volts, which is perfect for operating the AC. Click on the left or right thumbnail to watch our next videos and subscribe. Thank you.